shadow Earth starting at 10:29, the peak of the eclipse at 11:11, make a wish, and then it lasts until 11:53. It is going to appear this reddish coppery hue, and that's because the light that passes through the sun around the Earth will be red. So check it out. Usually we only get these in the wee hours of the morning. You won't have to set your alarms to see this one. The next time we'll see something like this won't be until 2029. So take advantage of this amazing celestial event. And we're tracking the viewing conditions for it on Sunday. Things are looking pretty good. Mostly clear for most of the models. A little bit of cloud cover showing up in a few of them. But if you're watching it for the totality of the lunar eclipse, it's an hour and 24 minutes. You should be good to go to catch that beautiful sight. A look out the door this morning, upper 70s for most spots, 78 degrees right now in Tomball, 79 for Pearland, Palacios, Angleton, the island view climbed into the 80s. In fact, let's take a look outside. We're seeing a little bit of cloud cover there along the island, and that is going to shortly start to break. Missouri City, mostly cloudy to start off your day. As we take a look downtown, not only cloudy, but a little bit hazy is the weather story for today. We are tracking a little bit of an air quality issue for today, so if you can avoid your time outdoors between 4 and 7 o'clock, that is recommended. In fact, 4 is when we'll feel the hottest. 90-degree days so far, 6. We're getting close to that very hot year in 2020, and we're tracking a 90 again for today, so we'll make it up to 7 90-degree days. But it is very insignificant. In fact, most of the energy from this low tracking towards Louisiana, towards Mississippi and Alabama, but we could see one little spot shower make its way into our area. If you do see any rain, consider yourself lucky, because the outlook from now until next weekend, zilch, no rain chance. We have to fast forward until the next Monday to see any green showing up in our models, and we really need it. The latest drought monitor came in on Thursday, and we are seeing that severe and extreme drought continuing to muscle its way into our area in dry conditions for the next 7 days.